My computer's been compromised. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Subscribe to Confident Computing, my weekly newsletter, for updates, comments, tips, and more. Newsletter.askleo.com. Sign up today. So, this is a lengthy question, but it's an interesting one that I hear from time to time. My computer security has been compromised. How can I rid my computer of a remote intruder? I've had this computer for about 5 or 6 years. I found out about the nefarious activities only after the person left my company. Although I can't think of anything of value, this person is extremely clever and smart. If getting rid of my computer and replacing it with a new one is the only way to unequivocally extract this spectator, I'll do it in a heartbeat. However, what safeguards must be in place from day one with a new computer to prevent the same thing from happening again? Plus prevent any and all intrusions, imparting absolute confidence in the security of my personal computer. Wow. Absolute confidence doesn't exist. As I say from time to time, there is no such thing as safe. There is only safer. While there are things we absolutely can and should be doing to be as safe as is possible, the reality of the situation is that there are no absolutes. However, let's first take a look at exactly what to do when you feel like your computer has been compromised. In a case like this, my gut reaction is that if you're in a situation where someone has installed malware on your machine, any form of malicious software, be it viruses, bots, spyware, remote access trojans, whatever, it's not your machine anymore. You don't know what that software could be doing without your knowledge. As you discovered, it could have been there for quite some time. It's simply the only safe assumption to make. If there's malware on your machine, it's not your machine anymore. So, what do you do? Well, to be clear, one of the things we want to do is remove the malware by running software that understands how to remove that particular piece of malware. The problem, of course, is that there are no guarantees. Malware may be removed. It may not even be found by anti-malware tools. The only way to guarantee that the malware is gone involves either of two scenarios. One, with the assumption you've been taking image backups of your machine this entire time, if you restore your machine to an image backup that was taken prior to the arrival of the malicious software, then you know that malicious software is gone. Note the prerequisites though. One, you've been taking image backups of this machine on some kind of a regular basis for some time, and you know when the malware arrived. If you can do those things, if you have those two things, then you can remove the malware by restoring your machine to prior to its arrival. Failing that, and to be clear, most people do fail that. They're either not taking backups or they really don't know when the malware arrived. There's really only one solution. You don't need to get a new machine. What you need to do is reformat and reinstall Windows from scratch. By that I mean reformat, erasing everything that's on the hard disk, which by definition gets rid of the malicious software, and then reinstalling Windows from scratch, reinstalling your applications from scratch, restoring your data from backups or wherever else is convenient, and then carrying on. That's the only way to know that you have removed malicious software from your machine. Now, how do you protect moving forward? Well, there are some things to at least pay a little bit of attention to. For example, especially if you've got a compromised Windows machine from someone who is somewhat clever, somewhat savvy, disable the administrator account. It's disabled by default on most machines, but like I said, if this guy was clever, he could have turned it back on. Or make sure to give it a good, strong password. Change it so that it's something that only you know. Ensure that your own login account on that machine, be it a local account or your Microsoft account, is itself properly secured with a strong password and whatever else is appropriate for that specific account. Make sure that Windows all of your applications are as up-to-date as possible to remove vulnerabilities that could potentially be used by someone to break into your machine. And finally, yeah, remember physical security. I don't know the scenario that we're describing here, but if someone has physical access to your machine, they have access to your machine and they can do almost anything to that machine simply by rebooting it. The other thing, and these are the more general steps that I talk about frequently, is you should review my article, Internet Safety, 7 Steps to Staying Safe Online. Much of this, especially these days, is a combination of security on your physical machine as well as online. In there, you will find the additional steps that I think are important to keep yourself secure and to keep this particular machine that you've certainly had a problem with secure as well. I hope that helps. I hope that helps moving you forward and feeling more secure. I can't give you absolutes. They don't exist, but we can make things much more secure and safer than they've been in the past. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2199. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.